Hello everyone, my name is Elliot Shylock. I'm a music producer and a composer. I'm a rapper and a singer. I mainly make pop, Afro pop to be specific, and hip hop. I've lived in Korea for almost 5 years now. It's been some time. It's been a great and amazing time. I've met some wonderful people and I enjoy my time in Korea. I do speak a little bit of Korean everyday life. Do you want to hear me speak some Korean?
Yeah.
Oh, 안녕하세요. 제 이름 엘리어트입니다. How was that? Was that good? Yeah, so just the end of last year, I started a contract with an LA-based production house. And right after that, I worked with a couple of students from K-Arts. We did a short film where I was partly composing and engineering the sound. It was a beautiful experience. And other than that, I've been composing some music. There's going to be a lot of music from Elliot Shylock this year. And a message to my fans, the neighbors, you know, there's going to be some wonderful, great music coming from me. If you don't know where to get me, Instagram is Elliot Shylock, Facebook is Elliot Shylock, and Twitter, Elliot Shylock, same as YouTube. So in the neighborhood, that's where you belong. I was in university and a friend of mine just asked me, he was like, hey man, I'm going to record some music, you wanna come with me? I was not a musician then. I was like, yeah, sure, let's do it. Fast forward, we went and they were recording and he asked me, just write something and say something on the mic. You know, put on some headsets and I was speaking on the microphone. When I heard the recording and I heard my own voice, there was just something amazing about that experience. I was like, I want to do it again. So that's where it started. You know, long story short, studying genetics and physiology at class 7 in the morning. And at night, I'm just busy recording, and I'm forgetting my class. So that's the one thing about inspiration. That's one thing, you know, finding what you love. It just grapples you and it doesn't leave you. So that's happened with me and my art. And that's where it started. And that started in 2017. It's 2024 and we're still going strong. I started off with FL Studio, but now I mainly use Pro Tools because if you step into any studio, you go to Gangnam in the studio and say, oh, Pro Tools. You go anywhere, it's like, oh, Pro Tools. So I had to learn Pro Tools. And because I compose for film as well, I do trailer music. I found that Pro Tools work better. So I use that. In terms of equipment, I'm a big fan of UAD. I use UAD equipment from microphone to interface, the plugins that I use. They have this amazing emulation of, you know, the pull tag, amazing emulation of just different classical plugins as well. His name is Quincy Jones, the great, you know. I read his book till today. It's like my inspiration. You know, I've never met the man, but I'm just, you know, inspired by him. He's also one of the reasons why I make music today. So it has to be Quincy Jones. When I first came to Korea, there was an artist called Bloom. Downtown, baby, yeah. You know, and I like that song, and that was the first artist that I was exposed to. I didn't know about, you know, K-pop then, but I think in Korea, Blue was that artist. I'm like, oh, I like it. You know, I like the flow, I like the style, and yeah, definitely Blue. I've gotten to a point where music is part of my life. Inspiration is literally everywhere. I'll tell you a little bit something. When I actually was on my way here, I used the subway. While I was on the subway, I was on my phone and I saw a picture, and that sparked the lyric already, and I started writing something, you know? So it literally comes from everywhere, anywhere. There are songs that started in the shower. You know, I was literally taking a shower and I heard one line. I keep repeating that line. Then I go compose, I put some chords, and then I'm like, oh, this is that. So that's how inspiration starts. I think when inspiration comes to that way, I think it comes from God. God, because sometimes what comes when you're in the shower is not, it's not a normal thing. It's not, sometimes not a cool thing. Sometimes it's a bit too vulnerable, but because it comes from God and you know you're a vessel, you put it in a record. I literally find it any and everywhere. Shows. I want to engage with my fans, engage with the neighbors, put more energy and more life and just, you know, more love to the neighborhood. So that's my plan. So you share my music, to be part of the neighborhood, to perform live. I can't wait to perform my music live. So that's definitely my plans for this year and my plans for 2024. Yeah, so in leaving, I'll share a poem, and it goes something along the lines of, the faster you take off, the harder the descent. The lower you circle, the more you bend. The more beautifully it begins, the uglier it ends. And the sharper the pain, the more we pretend. Now, these are parables, and chances are that you and I may not be able to comprehend these poems. But those who understand the language of experience, they know that it all comes together in the end. What does that mean? Go for the experience. You know, put yourself out there, experience, fail often, fix your mistakes, and keep going. And that's it from me. Elo Shalom. Love thy neighbor.